maak deur hom te probeer stenig. Nadat hulle nou 'n lang gesprek gehad het, kom hulle reg aan die einde in vers 59, Johannes 8 vers 59. Dis nou so kwaad, jy weet daai prentjie wat ons gesien het van die rook wat by die ore en die rook wat by die neus uitkom, hulle is so kwaad, hulle begin klippe optel en hulle doodgooi. Hulle het die klippe opgetel om te stenig, maar Jesus het stilletjies uit die tempel uitgegaan en tussen hulle deur geloop en so het hy vertrek. Hulle het die waarheid verwerp en die leuen geglo. The enemy told the Jews, you are righteous. You go to the temple, you are not a drunkard, you are not sleeping with rounders, and as long as you keep the law, you will be okay. But we know that they were not okay. The only way to get out of this state is to see our own sin and trust Jesus to save us. People that are so caught up in their own righteousness will find that people that they reckon as low class will enter the kingdom of heaven before them. Dis was erg vir hierdie ouens. In Matteus 21 vers 28, Matthew 21 vers 28. But what do you think? A man has two sons. And he came to the first and said, son, go work in my vineyard today. And he answered and said, I will not. But afterwards he repented and went. And he came to the second and said, likewise. And he answered and said, I go, sir. And did not go. Which of the two did the will of his father? They said to him, the first, Jesus said to them, truly I say to you that the tax collectors and the harlots go into the kingdom of God before you. Nou, ek hoop julle weet dat daardie tyd was a tax collector was the worst. They were not good people. They were not popular people. And Jesus said, the tax collectors and the harlots were going to enter into heaven before you. For John came to you in the way of righteousness and you did not believe him. But the tax collectors and the harlots believed him. And when you had seen it, you did not repent afterwards so that you might believe him. In other words, they heard the truth, but they rejected it. Another lie that the enemy uses is to tell you that you're a failure. He will tell you that you're a failure, you're useless. Jy's nie werd om enigiets te wees. Wie van julle al daai stem hoor? Jy gaan tot niks kom nie. You will not come to anything. The ultimate lie that it will come to you, and I'm not sure, maybe you have had this. It will be better for everyone if you are not in this world anymore. Why don't you go kill yourself? Weet jy hoeveel mense sit met dit? Miskien is dit beter as ek nie meer hier is. Dis 'n leer. Now this God to you all this. He's full of grace. He's full of mercy. He loved us when we were sinners. He loved us not because of what we do. He loved us because we are what we are. He's waiting for you and me to invite us into his life. Psalm 40 verse 1. David. I waited patiently for Jehovah. And he bowed down to me and he heard my cry. He brought me up out of a horrible pit, out of the miry clay, and set my feet on a rock and gave sureness to my steps. And he has put a new song in my mouth, praise to our God, many shall see it art and fear and shall trust in Jehovah. Blessed is the man who makes Jehovah his trust and does not turn to the proud, nor to those who turn aside for a lie. God did not provide David with a shovel and say to David, dig yourself out. Sometimes we say things like, it's okay, I can handle this. I can handle my situation. Wrong. Ek het al baie keer gedink, ek kan hierdie ding doen. Ek kan dit doen. Ek het nie hulp van enige iemand nodig. Maar ek het. Nobody helps you to become an addict. But you cannot be set free on your own. Jesus weet dat u en ek onsself wil vertrou. Lukas 18 vers 9. En hy het ook met die oog op sommige wat hulle self vertrou, dat hulle regverdig is, en die ander verag hierdie gelykenis vertel. En hy praat van die twee manne wat na die tempel gegaan het, een was 'n Fariseer en die ander een 'n tollenaar, 'n tekskollekteur. En die Fariseer het gaan staan en hom by homself so gebid: O God, ek dank U dat ek nie soos die ander mense is nie. Rowers, onregverdig is, egsbrekers of ook soos hierdie tollenaar. Ek vas 2 keer in die week, ek gee tiendes van alles wat ek kry. En die tollenaar het ver weg gestaan en wou selfs met sy oë na die hemel opheef. Maar het op sy bors geslaan en gesê: O God, wees my sondaar genadig. Ek sê vir julle, hierdie laaste een het regverdig na sy huis gegaan eerder as die eerste een, want elkeen wat homself verhoog sal verneder word, en hy wat homself verneder sal verhoog word. En ek wil afsluit. Ek weet nie waar wat is die omstandighede in die lewe nie, maar daar is een wat wel weet. Hy is goed bekend met elke ding in ons lewe, elke gedagte, elke aksie. He knows, and He's calling you today. We had this verse earlier, maar ek wil afsluit met dit, voordat ons gaan sit in die dag. Matteus 11 vers 8. Kom na my toe, almal wat vermoeid en belas is, en ek sal vir julle rus gee. Neem my juk op julle en leer van my, want ek is sagmoedig en nederig van hart, en julle sal rus vind vir julle siele, want my juk is sag en my las is lig. Moenie vanoggend 'n blinde oog draai. Moenie vanoggend sê ek kan dit in myself doen. Vat hom om sy woord. Hy sal jou rus gee. Ons maak ons woord. Vader, ons sê vir U baie dankie. Ek sê vir U dankie vir U woord. Dankie Here vir die feit dat ons kan sê, dat U sê vir ons, kom na my toe, almal wat vermoeid en belas is, ek sal vir julle rus gee. Vader, U ken elkeen wat hier sit vanmôre. My gebed is dat U vir elkeen rus sal gee. Dat U harte sal verander, dat U gesindhede sal verander, dat U ons lewens sal verander. In Jesus naam. Ek bid dan ook Vader dat U die brood en die druiwe sal seën aan ons liggaam as ons dit gebruik. Dat ons U liggaam identifiseer. Dat ons onsself identifiseer met Jesus se liggaam aan die kruis wat vir ons gebreek was en sy bloed wat vir ons gestort is. En ek vra dit in Jesus se wonderlike naam. Amen. Amen.